Tech Recruit. Today we are making something very amazing. Let's jump right into the video. Before we get started, like, share and subscribe to our channel and punch that notification bell. Let's get to it.
So guys, today we're making an awesome Indian street food, which happens to be a mixed vegetable and paneer frankie. So into a big mixing bowl goes 3 boiled and peeled potatoes, 1/3 cup of crumbled or shredded paneer. Now paneer is basically an Indian cheese. If you want to learn how to make it at home, I'm going to put the link down below of our recipe so you can try it out for yourself. Next, we're gonna add in 1 cup of boiled mixed veggies. So I basically took some frozen corn, carrots, peas, and green beans, gave it a quick little boil, and then we're gonna add that into our mixing bowl. Next, we're gonna add in 1-inch piece of ginger, finely chopped, 3 cloves of garlic, also finely chopped, and then 3 green chilies, say it with me, finely chopped. Next, let's add in juice from 1 lemon into the bowl. So what is a frankie, you ask? Well, a frankie is an Indian wrap that can often be described as an Indian or like a Mumbai burrito, and it involves making a cutlet, often with potatoes, and then wrapping it up in a paratha or an Indian bread. So once you have squeezed in your lemon juice, we're gonna start adding in our masalas. So first, we're gonna add in 1 teaspoon of cumin coriander powder, then 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, 1/4 teaspoon of red chili powder, salt to taste, 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, and then we're gonna add in 1/4 cup of breadcrumbs, which is gonna act as our binding agent. And then finally, we're gonna add in 1 tablespoon of sugar. Now comes the fun part, the one thing our parents told us not to do as kids, play with our food. So now, we're gonna start mashing the mix with our hands until it becomes one uniform patty mix. So, mash, 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 mash. Once you are done, this is what the cutlet mixture should look like. And now we're gonna start shaping it and cooking it. So to start shaping our cutlets, take a nice handful of the mixture and you're just going to shape it into a long rectangular roll, kind of like a really big mozzarella stick. Then set it aside on a plate and continue forming the rest of your cutlets. Once you are done portioning and shaping out enough cutlets, we're going to start cooking them. So take a pan and set it to about a medium heat, and to that add in 1 to 2 teaspoons of oil. Once your oil is hot enough, and the way you know this is when it starts moving around kind of like water, you're gonna add in your cutlets. Cook for a few minutes on both sides until the cutlets start to brown up a little bit and form a crispy outer layer like you can see here. Once your cutlet is cooked, you can set it aside on a plate for later when we start assembling. After our cutlets are all cooked, we can then move on to the next component of our dish, which is gonna be our parathas, which will be the thing that we wrap the entire dish in. So we made some paratha dough earlier, and we're gonna start rolling it out into big circles. If you wanna learn how to make parathas at home, I'm gonna add a link to our paratha recipe down below as well so you can try it out for yourself. Once you have rolled out your dough, place it on a hot pan and cook on both sides until nice and golden brown. In the meantime, let's make our sauce. So in a bowl, we have about 2 tablespoons of mayo, and then we're gonna add in some hot sauce. Not just any hot sauce though, I'm using one of my favorites, it's called Bomb Banana. It is super delicious and it has a really nice sweet and spicy taste that goes great in this recipe. So I'm gonna add the link to their website in the description, so definitely check it out and you can try some of that hot sauce for yourself. Next, add in 2 teaspoons of coriander chutney, and we're also gonna add in a teaspoon of ketchup. You can use regular or spicy Maggi ketchup. Give it all a nice little mix, 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 and then set it aside until we are ready to assemble. After a few minutes, it should be time to flip our paratha as well, so apply some oil to your paratha before you flip it over and cook it on the other side. Once your paratha is cooked, we are going to be ready to assemble. So first take your sauce and apply it all over your paratha. You want a nice even layer. Then place 1 cutlet in the center of the wrap and top it with some shredded lettuce, a few pieces of red onion, and then grate some cheese on top. We're using some Amul sharp white cheddar cheese, but you can use pepper jack, you can use yellow cheddar, whatever you feel like using. Finally, we're gonna top it with some frankie masala, which is basically just amchur, which is dried mango powder, chaat masala, salt, and pepper all combined together. Once that is done, we are ready to roll up our beauty. Now the time has come, the best part of the video. It is time to taste, enjoy, and cook it for yourself.
Now it's time to taste our frankie. This is amazing. It It is so good. I think everyone should try this at home. Hope you like the video. Try it out at home and keep on cooking.